Milagro is hilarious. I love Milagro. She's very independent. She's outspoken. She's blunt. You know, she's just extremely honest to the point where people probably are like, she is so rude. But she just tells it like it is. You know, she doesn't like to beat around the bush. She's a realist, you know, versus Jaime, who's kind of like optimistic and, you know, very hopeful. And Milagro's always been like, dude, come on, bro. Like, that's not going to happen, you know, which I've always loved about their relationship. But Milagro's an artist. She's very, very passionate about her artwork, her community, how those two come together. And she's always felt that that's, you know, that was her purpose, or that is her purpose, is to be an artist and to bring that to the community. With Jaime, she relates because they are first generation kids. And so that's always a very specific experience. So they kind of get to share that together, which is very nice. And I mean, I of course they always had like their sibling tiffs or whatever. But I think for Milagro, Jaime has always been like a really positive figure in her life. And I think they relate to their love for their community and their family. I think how important family is, I think they both are very connected on that. I think visual style, especially like with the bug layer and the bug ship, I find it to be very retro, kind of like that old style 80s neon lighting and all of that. And even, I mean, even the gadgets, you know, Ted Kord's lair has been lost in time for a long time. And so it's a time capsule. When we go back into the lair and the bug ship, it hasn't been used in like 15 years, something like that. So it everything takes you back. And I love that about it. It feels very nostalgic. The family is super close-knit. I mean, I think there are no secrets within that family, just impossible. Very supportive in other ways. I know the art is a big one that they go against, but I think the mom is the only one. I think everyone else in the family is very much like, Milagro is just Milagro, and we love her for it. You know, we're not trying to change her. But the family, they do everything together. And sometimes that can be very frustrating. but yeah, they're super close-knit, and they've been through a lot together. There's definitely some strong, strong bonds there. It's got so much comedy in there, which is so nice, but it really has, there's heart to the story also. There's the family aspect, there's the meeting of these two people from totally different worlds, and these two families that are just so opposite. And you see how, you see the differences, the similarities, you see this town. I mean, it just, the story touches on so many things, and it brings so many things into perspective, all while keeping it light, keeping it fun, keeping it action-packed, visually pleasing. I mean, there's just so much in it. I think the essence of Blue Beetle is bravery. I think that's, you know, all the characters have their moments of bravery in the movie. And I think that's a lot of what Animo is too, you know, and that's our catchphrase, all of the movie. That's what we tell each other, because that's what it means, you know, be brave, be strong, and like, don't go in with fear.